Hi guys, welcome to this video session. Submerged arc welding. It is a type of arc welding process in which arc has been produced between continuous flood electrode and the metal. And moreover, the arc has been submerged under the granular flux. Hence, it is called as submerged arc welding. The parts of the submerged arc welding are, it has flux harbor, electrode wire, drive roller, and it requires DC power supply. This animation shows how submerged arc welding working principles carried out. This is the overall setup of submerged arc welding. It is used for vertical movement, and this is used for horizontal movement, and electrode wire fed through the system. Rollers are moving upward direction. In this welding, an electric arc is produced between consumable bare electrode and the workpiece. The metal electrode is fed continuously from the reel by moving head. The flux powder is fed in front of the moving head. When the arc is produced in the weld zone at the end of the electrode, and the arc is completely covered by flux powder. Some of the flux metals and forms slag on the weld. The unused flux is sucked by using a pipe. This is how a completed weld looks like. The advantage of submerged arc welding are, it has high deposit rate. It can be easily automated. Very small welding smoke can be observed. No edge training is required for this welding process. This method of welding can be used both indoor as well as outdoor. No chance of welding sprinkles because it is submerged within flux blanket. The disadvantages: this process is incomplete to some particular metal, and at the same time this application is imperfect to direct seam vessels and pipes. Chances of health problem are more because of high flux usage. Slag elimination is desirable after welding process. Applications: the submerged arc welding can be used to weld pressure vessels like boilers, structural outlets, pipes, earth moving tools, shipbuilding, railroad construction, and locomotives. Atomic hydrogen welding. It is also a type of arc welding process. In this welding, arc is produced between two non-consumable electrodes, and these two non-consumable electrodes are surrounded by two pipes. These two pipes are used to pass the hydrogen gas. This hydrogen gas acts the shielding gas for this arc. Heat is generated from the arc, causes the metals to melt. Thus, joining happens. This small animation explains how hydrogen arc welding takes place. These two are two tungsten electrodes. They are non-consumable electrodes. These two tungsten electrodes are covered by two pipes. This is the shield through which the operator can hold these two tungsten electrodes. The other end of the shield used to supply the power. This electric current causes the tungsten electrode to get heated up, and thus arc produced between them. These two electrode holder firmly holds these two tungsten electrode. These are the two metal pieces are going to join together. Hydrogen gas cylinder. Is controlled by a gas regulator valve and a pipe connects the cylinder to the pipe surrounded the tungsten electrode. When power supply is on, electric power passes through the tungsten electrode and thus causes arc produced between these two electrodes at the tip. At the same time, hydrogen gas supply is started by controlling the regulator valve. This hydrogen gas acts as the shielding gas for this arc. The heat generated by the arc causes the hydrogen to get ionized. That means the H2 atom is divided into two H electrons. When these two hydrogen ions move towards the metal pieces, its temperature decreases. Thus, because of this coldness, due to the decrease in the temperature, the hydrogen ions start to join together. During this process, heat is liberated. This heat causes the metals to melt, thus the joining takes place. This is the working principle of atomic hydrogen arc welding. Advantages of atomic hydrogen arc welding are: no flux or separate shielding gas are used in this process. The arc remains between two tungsten electrodes can be moved to other parts easily without getting extinguished. Welding of thin material is also possible in this welding process. Due to high concentration of heat, welding can be carried out at faster rate. Disadvantages. This process cannot be used for depositing large quantities of metals. Welding speed is less as compared to that of other metallic arc welding. This process becomes uneconomical for certain applications because of high operating cost. These are all some disadvantages of atomic hydrogen arc welding applications. This process can be used for welding most of the metal and its alloy like plain carbon steel, alloy steel, stainless steel, aluminium, copper, nickel, and their alloys. Thank you.